What good can come out of Sungai Petani?
It was here that a young boy was born who would in time lead the local church to greater heights and become one of the great sons of the local church.
Anthony Soter was born to Anthony and Susanna Fernandez on 22nd April 1932 at Sungai Petani, Kedah. War disrupted his early education in Taiping. However, he continued his education at St. Theresa's School and Ibrahim School in his hometown. Having lost his father at the age of 14, the responsibility of caring for the family was thrust upon him. In 1947, Soter was employed as a hospital assistant at the Sungai Tawar Estate and Baling Road Group Hospitals. However, God had a plan for Soter and planted the seeds of a priestly vocation in his heart. Two eminent churchmen were responsible for showing and moving Soter along the path to the priesthood. One was the late Monsignor Ignatius Aloysius, the first Vicar General of Penang Diocese, and the other was Archbishop Emeritus Dominic Van Dagen. Soter first met Father Aloysius in 1940 when he was an 8-year-old lad. This exemplary priest, who made a deep impression on him, gave Soter the greatest gift by his model priestly life.
The other person who encouraged Soter's vocation was Father Van Dagen, who was his guide and mentor. Soter first met him in 1941, when he celebrated Mass at Soter's home. 14 years later, at his episcopal ordination, Bishop Van Dagen posed a big question that was to ring in his ears for some time.
Hey, Soter, are you still thinking of becoming a priest?
The nurturing efforts of both priests, Father Aloysius and Father Van Dagen, bore fruit in 1958 when Soter entered the Singapore Minor Seminary and completed his studies in College General in Penang. On completion of his priesthood studies, Deacon Soter was ordained priest by Bishop Dominic Van Dagen on 10th December 1966 at the Cathedral of the Assumption, Penang. Father Soter served as assistant priest and in 1969 became a full-fledged parish priest of the Church of St. Louis in Taiping. After 2 years as a parish priest, he went for further studies in catechetics. From 1971 to 1972, he studied at the East Asian Pastoral Institute in the Philippines and later at the National Biblical, Catechetical and Liturgical Center in India. On his return, this young and visionary priest formed catechetical groups in the Diocese of Penang. With his knowledge and experience, he was chosen in 1973 to teach at College General. 2 years later, Father Soter was appointed to the prestigious position of Rector of College General in recognition of his leadership qualities.
During his tenure as Rector, Father Soter became the force behind the Five Loaves and Two Fishes team, comprising graduates of the East Asian Pastoral Institute. It was this team that initiated a program that would change the course of pastoral life in the Peninsular Malaysia Church. The convening of the historic Ajournamento in 1976 paved the way for renewal in the local church. The building of basic Christian communities, later to be called basic ecclesial communities, became the central thrust of the church in Peninsular Malaysia. About a year later, his pastoral excellence and long-term vision were given due recognition when the highest order of the Catholic Church was bestowed on him. On 29th September 1977, he was elected to become the third Bishop of Penang by Pope Paul VI. Father Soter was consecrated bishop by Archbishop Gregory Yong on 17th February 1978. Bishop Soter chose Keadilan dan Keamanan, or justice and peace, as his motto. His zeal in moving the local church forward took on a new challenge. When his mentor, Archbishop Van Dagen, retired, Bishop Soter was elevated and installed Archbishop of the Metropolitan Archdiocese of Kuala Lumpur on 10th November 1983.
First as Bishop of Penang and then as Archbishop of Kuala Lumpur, Archbishop Soter has always exercised his role as shepherd with diligence, patience and compassion. The pastoral growth and spiritual development of his flock has always been his top priority. In August 1996, Archbishop Soter spearheaded the PMPC2, in which the vision and mission of the local church was spelt out in the context of the new way of being church. This vision and mission was conveyed to the faithful through pastoral animation and formation sessions, popularly called the Bishop's Roadshow. In October 1999, under his guidance, the Archdiocesan Pastoral Assembly adopted a 10-point pastoral plan. In this plan, interreligious and ecumenical dialogue were identified as integral to the mission of the local church. The following year, in November 2000, Archbishop Soter inaugurated the Archdiocesan Pastoral Council, which culminated the many years and several stages of representation and consultation in the Archdiocese under the guidance of the Archbishop. In October 2001, he stressed the importance of BECs when he directed that Wednesday evenings be reserved exclusively for BEC gatherings and BEC-related activities. After the Jubilee Year 2000, Archbishop Soter guided the local church in identifying the family as a priority. Renewing family life was chosen as the theme for the years 2001 to 2006.
Social justice and peace were subjects close to his heart. He started a group that met monthly to discuss social issues, and eventually in 1983, Bishop Soter established the Justice and Peace Commission for the Penang Diocese. After he moved to Kuala Lumpur, he continued taking up justice and peace issues in line with his motto. Recognizing his stand on justice and peace issues, Archbishop Soter was elected chairman of the Office for Human Development of the Federation of Asian Bishops' Conferences in 1984. During the PMPC in 1986, together with his brother bishops, Archbishop Soter was instrumental in appealing against the amendments to the Official Secrets Act. The following year, in response to Operation Lalang in October 1987, Archbishop Soter, together with the Peninsula bishops, urged the government to release the detainees, which included church personnel held under the Internal Security Act. The three bishops of Peninsula Malaysia jointly issued a pastoral letter calling the ISA immoral. In August 2002, on behalf of the regional bishops, Archbishop Soter issued a declaration on the growing politicization of Islam in Malaysia. Archbishop Soter has also made a stand on international justice and peace issues. In October 2002, he strongly protested the planned demolition of Palestinian homes. In May 2001, and again in January 2003, Archbishop Soter, on behalf of the church in this region, called for the lifting of economic sanctions and spoke against the use of military force on Iraq. In furtherance of the cause of peace, and on behalf of Christian churches, Archbishop Soter denounced war and violence at a peace rally of 200,000 people on 23rd February 2003.
Interreligious dialogue is another subject that Archbishop Soter took a keen interest in. He has actively pursued understanding, unity and cooperation among the religions in Malaysia. On the Universal Day of Fast on December 14, 2001, Archbishop Soter broke fast with a Muslim family to enhance dialogue and solidarity between the two religions. In July 1999, he called for a colloquium on interreligious harmony to explore concrete ways to realize interreligious dialogue. The gathering brought together religious leaders so that Catholics would have a better understanding of other faiths. Archbishop Soter has consistently supported dialogue among the members of the Malaysian Consultative Council for Buddhism, Christianity, Hinduism and Sikhism, or MCCBCHS. In 2001, as representative of the Catholic Church, the Archbishop was elected president of MCCBCHS for a 2-year term. In line with the Archdiocesan Pastoral Plan, Archbishop Soter has promoted ecumenism for a greater understanding among those who share the Christian faith. As a representative of the Catholic Church and on behalf of the Christian Federation of Malaysia, he hosted the Christmas Open House for the Prime Minister in December 2001.
The efforts of his predecessor, Tan Sri Dominic Bendagan, to develop the local church were further strengthened by Archbishop Soter, who also initiated, implemented and undertook new challenges and programs, not only for the Archdiocese of Kuala Lumpur, but also for the peninsula and country. After almost 12 years of shepherding the flock, Archbishop Soter consecrated Father Murphy Parkim, who was appointed Auxiliary Bishop of Kuala Lumpur, to assist him with the pastoral care of the faithful. Archbishop Soter is a people's bishop, a steward with a vision to renew the local church and to promote the values of the Kingdom of God. He has an unwavering hope of a church that is in tune with the signs of the times. He continues to journey with his people in faith and love, always keeping before him his motto, justice and peace. When Archbishop Soter began his episcopacy, he quoted the renowned St. Augustine, "For you I am a bishop, with you I am a fellow pilgrim." For the past 25 years, his life is witness to the highest ideals of good pastorship. On 16 February 2003, Archbishop Soter celebrated the silver jubilee of his episcopal ordination.
Archbishop of the Bagani, Apostolic Nunavik Malaysia, and representative of Beloved Holy Father, Reverends Cardinal Julius Dabat Maria, Archbishop of Jakarta, Presidency Renato Martino, President of the Pontifical Council of the Justice and Peace in Rome, formerly our Apostolic Nunavik, Your Excellencies, Bishops and Archbishops, Your Excellencies, the Ambassadors present here, dear brothers and sisters. As always, Bishop Murphy has made things very easy for me. All the happenings, whether it's the liturgical or the other functions that we have, he has been the inspiration or soul of this team, not made of the individuals or the human parents, the children, the whole team, little boys, little girls, parents, or team of all things. Everyone has participated. And all of us are present here. Mention has been made already, but I'd like to ask you to turn on that side. There are very special people, very special friends who are across the road in Bukit Nanas, Achama, Asama, Chaya. Some are blind, some are deaf and dumb, some cannot walk about, and we have a special team there to sign the language for them while it's happening. So, I believe in our lives we include all, exclude none. That's one of the calls for us as Christians. So I take inspiration also for all of us today, where it says in the second reading, whatever you do at all, do it for the glory of God. Whatever you do at all, do it for the glory of God. It is what each of us is called to do in our own lives, vocation, and our mission. Never do anything offensive to anyone. It's all fine, but this is what we're coming to all of us here. And we pray also, we say, help us to live in your presence. Definitely God's presence in our lives. So my special request is, before I want to thank His Excellency, is that all of us present here, come from different countries, different locations of life. Malaysia, In Malaysia, we must be the soul of Malaysia. All this about peace and all, we must. Prayer is very important and very, very powerful. If today we don't have the rain now, it is because of our prayer for this. And very soon the rain will come because showers are blessings. When things are over, they become showers of blessings. So, Excellency, I'm deeply indebted to our Holy Father. Allow me to just share with our people two of my encounters with Holy Father. Many encounters. One is 1984, when His Excellency was the nuncio and personal delegate of Malaysia, and the Holy Father is coming to Thailand. There's no possibility of having him here. And so His Excellency invited the archbishops. It happened to just be in Kuala Lumpur in 1984, 1 year, for lunch. So it was lunch, you know, my father was sleeping a long time, very tired. So I took the opportunity to get out and meet with him. And I told him this, Holy Father, I thank you for the confidence you have in appointing me as Archbishop of Kuala Lumpur. You know what he did? He embraced me and said, I am your brother. That's all. Second was in 1990, I had this heart business, went for repair, heart repair. So all the bishops went to Rome for the annual visit, and including our Archbishop Emeritus Dominic Van Dalen, who is under my employee, not able to be here this day, but I went and saw him and got his blessing too. If you look forward to the year 2005, then 50 years bishop and organized in 50 years. So I was chosen to go for the visit the next year, following year, and I asked the Apostle Archbishop to go that if I could get an audience with the Holy Father since I missed. And on a Sunday I had a note sent to me saying next day, Monday, after doing the same coffee break, the Holy Father will meet with me. And so I comprehend it was the day of his election for 16 October 1981. So I came when I was made an act of faith. So I went and learned on and said, Holy Father, I wish to affirm my faith that you are the vicar of Christ on earth and the successor of Peter. It was taken aback, you know. That's the faith we have in our Holy Father. Just to share how He loves us and He trusts us too. I thank Your Excellency for reading the message for us. And as mentioned, those who have come here, especially His Eminence and His Grace, and they're going back tomorrow. So quite a number have come from different countries, as you say. I'm not sure many have come from different places. Just for this, thank God, to glorify God together. And thanks to all who are present, and I just want to say a few words in different languages, because I will stay back here afterwards to have the opportunity to say thanks to each one of them. So, terima kasih, asana sana sanari, nambanda sana sanari, SNE, and thank you power to my listening brothers, and so this is continue to praise God and thank Him and participate in the life of the society and the church. They mentioned what? Society and church. So let us thank God for His gift and continue and really have the blessing and hopefully God's blessing also with the Apostle Terry, His grace. Thank you.
Grace. And the music written by His Lordship Bishop Park Hume.
Who would believe that I could be happy and contented? I used to think that happiness hadn't been invented. But that was in the bad old days before I met you. But the man I had you walk into my heart. Congratulations and celebrations. When I tell everyone that you're in love with me. Congratulations and jubilations. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be.
Fathers, fathers, take a bow.
May the good Lord bless your grace. May the good Lord bless you. Blow the king out. Cake. He's very obedient. And now eat the cake.
Anulum de manu Petri et nobiles, dilectione principis apostolorum, dilectione tuan erga ecclesiam roborari, ad honorem Dei omnipotentis et santorum apostolorum Petri et Pauli, tibi comitimus titulum Santi Alberti Magni, in nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti.